Dear students, today we are going to talk about cycle of magnetization, and which is also called hysteresis loop. Why we call it hysteresis loop? We shall be talking about it. So let us understand what is cycle of magnetization. When we magnetize a magnetic material, say for example we have a piece of iron which is unmagnetized, but it is a magnetic material, means at the elementary level each atom is a magnet and they have non-zero magnetic dipole moment. But since they are randomly arranged, they cancel each other's effect, so the net magnetism do not appear outside the material. Therefore, that is unmagnetized. But at the elementary level, every atom or molecule is magnetic in nature. So here we are going to magnetize a magnetic material. I have drawn a graph over here. Here we are plotting two factors. One is the external magnetizing field, which is magnetizing the material, and due to that the magnetization is produced in the material, or intensity of magnetization, whatever you say. So we take the sample, and for example we start with the value of H increasing from 0 to a maximum value. So that when this happens, means when the external magnetizing field is increased gradually from a value 0 to a maximum value, say H1, the intensity of magnetization increases in the material as shown by the dotted line. Means you can understand when the magnetizing field is increasing in its magnitude, the intensity of magnetization will increase. But how much increase will be there, that it becomes saturated after certain point. You can understand the reason behind it. But because if all the elementary magnetic dipoles are arranged in one particular direction, or maximum at that temperature due to thermal energy, some might not be arranged along the same direction. So that means when the maximization is done, then no further increase in magnetic field, that is intensity of magnetization, do not increase any further, even if the external magnetizing field is increased. So that means the saturation of magnetization takes place at point A for a given external magnetizing field H1. And if we increase the external magnetizing field from this value H1, still the intensity of magnetization do not increase, that is, therefore we call it saturation of magnetization. Now when we start decreasing the value of external magnetizing field from the maximum value H1 and gradually decreasing it to a value 0, so accordingly when this external magnetizing field is decreased, the intensity of magnetization decreases from a maximum value to a certain value OB. That means when the external magnetizing field is removed, still some magnetization is retained by the material, therefore we call it retentivity of the material. Means OB represents the retentivity, means whatever magnetization was produced in the body, even when the external magnetizing field was made to be zero, still it retained some magnetic field. So intensity of magnetization retained by it is known as retentivity of the material. Now we further decrease the external magnetizing field as it is already zero. So we will decrease it, it means it becomes negative, means the external magnetizing field is now is reversed in its direction. So that means it becomes negative in terms of the previous external magnetizing field. So that means when this value is decreased further, H value is decreased further, the intensity of magnetization decreases from B to a value 0 at point C for certain negative value of H. And that value of H for which the intensity of magnetization is 0, that value of H in negative side is known as coercivity. Means this much magnetization which was retained by the material was eliminated from the material by some coercive force, by applying some negative external magnetizing field on the material to make it zero. Now, if the external magnetizing field is further decreased, means it is made more negative and greater in magnitude, then the intensity of magnetization now is developed in the reverse direction as of the previous case. As compared to the previous direction of magnetization, now the intensity of magnetization is developed in negative direction and it increases from a zero value for at point C, corresponding to point C, it becomes maximum at point D for a certain value of H is equal to minus H2. So that means minus H2. That means now again this is such magnetization is saturated. Now any further decrease in value of H, the intensity of magnetization do not increase. And that is called saturation of intensity of magnetization. Now if we increase the value of H from minus H2 and then and make it up to zero, then what happens? The intensity of magnetization which was in negative direction becomes gradually becomes zero. By increasing its value, it becomes zero from negative value to becomes the external magnetizing field becomes zero, but the intensity of magnetization becomes from a saturation point value to a certain value OE. That OE is nothing but again the retentivity, and it is always that OE is equal to OB. So retention is there, means the intensity of magnetization is retained, some magnetism is retained by the material again. And when we further increase the value of H from zero value corresponding to point E to certain value OF corresponding to point F, then the intensity of magnetization in the material which was in reverse direction now becomes zero. Means for point F, H value is OF and intensity of magnetization is zero. And that value of OF is known as coercivity, which is again equal to, always equal to OC. OF is always equal to OC. Now if we further increase the value of H from this value OF and make it equal to H1, the magnetization is saturated at point A again. So that means if we further increase the intensity of the magnetizing field, the intensity of magnetization will not increase when the H value is attaining H1 value, and any further in value of H from H1 do not bring any change in the intensity of magnetization of the material. So that means this is how the whole cycle is completed. You don't consider this dotted line as a part of cycle because it is initially a starting point which is making us grab the cycle. Now you see this, the whole phenomena will be repeated on time and again if we follow the same process of increasing the value of H or decreasing the value of H as discussed earlier. So that means what you see, that certain loss of energy is taking place. More is the area of this loop, greater is the loss of energy, and therefore this is called hysteresis loss, means loss, loop of loss. So greater is the area, greater will be the loss, and therefore it happens when you subject some magnetic material to a hysteresis loop or cycle of magnetization, you will feel that the material gets heated. Why this happens? Because of the magnetism is retained by it even if the external magnetic field is zero. And that to remove this, extra work has to be done by the external magnetizing field, and therefore this is the loss of energy. Now we shall be learning more about these things, the applications of this cycle of magnetization in so many fields, especially in transformer, where we select certain material for which we have the minimum area of cycle of magnetization so that the loss of energy is minimum, wastage of energy is minimum. And for many other applications we shall be talking about it as and when we talk in the coming chapters. We will find the application of this and we shall be discussing it in details about these things when we come across those topics where we have find some application of this fact which we have learned right now. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.